It's a new year and spring cleaning will be here before you know it. And for homeowners looking to fix up the yard and work on some new projects, dealing with clogged drains is one of those pesky problems no one wants to deal with. Well, joining us this morning with tips to help avoid that problem, Stephen Wood, Operation Manager of Woods Rooter Service. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
It's good to have you here this morning. We're all looking forward to spring. We're all looking forward to having a lot of people over. Nothing worse than having a party and someone says, I may have poured something down the sink and it's blocked. Let's go over some of the things that you should never, ever pour down the drain.
Biggest things is grease. A lot of times people use in their cooking oils and that'll clog your sinks. Another things that you don't want to put down is chicken bones and the heavy rice and beans and the beef stew, all that stuff down your garbage disposals, because that's just going to grind it up and turn it into a big grease problem. That's a big common problem. Other than that, for sinks, that's not really too big of an issue. Your
sure.
big problems for your clogged drains is your main lines. Those are where the big issues come
okay.
play.
Okay. All right. So if you do have a problem, and maybe it's not a problem that happens all the time, is it okay to pour some of like a Drano or something like that?
I wouldn't, for something small. I wouldn't recommend it because a lot of houses are older. They're not all new constructions, and the Dranos and the other products of the world, they're all acidic. They can cause damage to your copper lines, old lead lines. So I wouldn't recommend it. I would try snaking it yourself or
right.
calling a guy like you.
Okay, so if I have a problem at the house, I pick up the phone, I call a guy like you. What's the first thing you're going to do when you come out to my house?
Well, I'm going to go step by step through my annuals, and I'm going to check out everything that's going on in the house and figure out what's actually backing up, and then I'm going to go ahead and take care of it, snaking it first, as always, mm-hmm. and then probably doing a line flush of the sorts and force some water through it to make sure that the clog makes it to the street.
Is dealing with someone whose house is on like a septic tank different from someone whose house is on main line like a city sewer system?
Absolutely. Septic tanks, a lot of the times the water tables, groundwater comes into play with that. And
right.
then the city sewers, a lot of cities will come out and actually help you when the cities are backed up.
Right.
And they'll blow out the clogs themselves. But a lot of people don't know that your city sewer, you own everything up until where you touch the city sewer. So homeowners think that they can just call the city because it's from the street out.
But actually, that's your responsibility.
Yes,
that's your
is.
Responsibility.
Yes.
Okay, for anyone out there who doesn't know what snaking is, tell us what equipment you bring out and how long it usually takes for you to actually clear out the system.
Snaking is a giant machine. It's a 3/4-inch steel cable
mm-hmm.
or an 11/16-inch steel cable with a bunch of different size cutters on it that we send through the pipes, and they actually spin and rotate to the diameter of the pipes, and they cut out anything from roots, feminine products, your heavy, good brand toilet papers, and things of the sorts, heavy grease, for instance. And we just takes probably about an hour and a half. Generally, if it's heavy roots in the sewer line, then it might take you a couple more hours, but we always plan for that accordingly.
Yeah, so. What are you able to do? Because a lot of homes here in New England, they're older homes. A lot of the trees yeah. are these giant oak trees, pine trees that have been around forever, and their roots are strong roots, and they start going through these pipes, and there really isn't any way that really preventing that, right?
Exactly. There's no telling how fast the roots are going to grow or when it's going to happen to
sure.
you. Best way to figure out when it's starting to happen is when, say, the lowest point in your house for the water is your washing machine drain in the basement.
Mm-hmm.
If that thing starts draining slow on you, you know you're starting to have an issue.
Okay.
I would have it rooted out. And a lot of the times you don't want to have the small cutters in your sewer line.
Sure.
So a guy like me, being a drain cleaning expert, you always want to try and get the biggest cutters in the sewer line.
Just to make sure everything's cleaned out.
Everything's free and clear. And when it comes to roots, you always want to make sure that you're doing your due diligence and take your time. Put some effort into it and not just poke a hole in it, get it to drain.
All right, all good stuff. So if you do have a problem, don't do it yourself. Call a guy like this. Thanks so much for coming in today.
You're very welcome.
Nice to meet you. Nice to have you here.
Yeah.
And if you missed any of these tips or want to learn more about Woods Rooter Service, all you have to do is head to our website, WPRI.com/theroadshow.